It is, it is. You sit there, Jean, your favourite corner, your favourite spot. Well, hello, you multi shenanigans. You, Ralphie here, Whiskey Review 120. And not so long ago, it was St. Patrick's Day. Let me see, was it the 17th of March? Something like that. And all around the world, things got kind of green and emeraldish. And I must say that I had even had a glass of green ale myself, courtesy of my friends who put food colouring in it. But there we go, each to their own. It was still okay. Enjoyed the beer. I will not be putting green food colouring in this. This is the first of our Irish whiskies for an individual review. Bushmills. The most northerly, excuse me, Jean, just move over a wee bit. Easy does it in the whisky. The most northerly distillery on the island of Ireland. And the version I've chosen to present to you is one of the most available, easily got Bushmills. It's the basic 1608. Simple, straightforward, blended whiskey. Now, Irish whiskey by its nature is relatively light compared to Scotch. And therefore, when blended with grain whiskey, it can really be very good depending on the quality of the grain. Now, fortunately, with this little version, we're on sound, solid ground. It's fine. Another Bushmills, which I've already reviewed at Chippermore Point, was the Black Bush. So there's the Black Bush, which I gave a good review to, which is a good whisky, quite sherry influenced. This one, the White Bush, is really sort of lighter, fresher, more bourbon influenced. It has all the typical trappings of a branded mass production product, as they call it, for the consumers. That's us. We call ourselves customers, but we won't quibble on that one. And a little bit, while this is opening up, a little bit about Bushmills. It claims to be the oldest distillery in the world, with a launch date of 1608. Now, 1608 was in fact when the license was granted for distillation. And it was generally considered in the olden days that Irish whiskey was a lot more palatable, lighter in texture and safer than the rougher stuff, the coarse and heavy flavoured stuff coming from the rest of the British Isles. Hence the reason Irish whiskey had a very good reputation in the early days. And there was plenty of distilleries around then. However, it was prohibition in the United States which kind of put paid to a lot of the distilleries, which had to shut down. I think at one point there was about 60 in Ireland, and that's not including those illegal ones which were dotted here and there and everywhere. Effectively, the distillery started producing about 1784, according to my notes, and Bushmills is one of four working distilleries in Ireland. Now, I completely lost my memory in Whiskey Review 119, so I'm going to rectify that immediately in here in Whiskey Review 120 by stating the four working distilleries in Ireland. With the north, you've got Bushmills, technically Old Bushmills, a big industrial unit owned by Diageo, geared up for volume production with vast warehouses in the fields beyond it. I visited Bushmills a couple of years ago, last year in fact, with biker friends when we were over for the Northwest Racing, which was very exciting, and we really loved the place, apart from the weather. The weather was rotten. I must say, the bottling plant, which wasn't actually working while we were there, the bottling plant, which is attached to Bushmills Distillery, is without doubt one of the cleanest I have ever seen in my life. Very organised, very professional for a volume producer. I did sample some of the older Bushmills whisky, but I must say it is a slight improvement, if anything, on your basic stuff. There's a certain amount of complexity, but not such a huge amount. It's not the nature of the whisky. Other distilleries are Middleton, which is the most southerly of the Irish distilleries, which produces Jameson's and Redbreast and some of the Napogue Castles and Paddy's and Greenspot. So Middleton at Jameson's, they're producing a traditional pot still whisky. More about that later. Then that's owned by Pernod Ricard, by the way, who also owns Chivas Regal. Now, getting on to the independents, one of the largest independent distilleries is Cooley, just outside of Dublin. So if you get over to Dublin for the weekend, I think it would be worth taking a trip. Phone them up in advance and see if they'll give you a wee turn around their distillery. They're producing such artisan treats as Tyrconnell and the double distilled, slightly peated Connemara, which I will be reviewing later. Also, Kilbeggan, which is right in the centre of Ireland, and it's producing a few little bits and pieces, but it's not really up and running in full production yet. And then proposed is a fifth distillery right down on the south of Ireland, Dingle. Very much a small craft type distillery, and we wish the guys all the luck in getting that distillery up and running. As I say, as a Scotsman who knows my Scotch whisky, I always enjoy turning to Irish whisky, as I enjoy turning to rums and Armagnacs and Mezcals, etc., because you need a change. Now and again, you do need a change to save you getting too stale with your appreciation of one single spirit type. Moving on. Nose. Creamy. Vanilla. Slight spice. Touch of menthol. Fresh apple. Cooking apple. Slight bitterness. Fizzy sherbet lemon. It's happening quietly, but there's a lot happening there for a light blended whisky. If adding water to an Irish whiskey at 40% drops, it's too light to take too much water. Flavour. The flavour is really a follow-on from what's on the nose, with toffee, milk chocolate, grain, barley sugar, fudge. It arrives gently, it evolves gently, although short-lived, and it finishes relatively gently. It's a great, good quality mixing or occasional sipping whiskey. This whiskey with ice, no problem at all. If you want to sip it on its own, au naturel, you won't have a problem either. It isn't spectacular. It doesn't rock the world, but it gives it a slight nudge. Marks, 83 out of 100, and that's a blend mark. So, Jean and I will be back shortly to review some more fine Irish whiskies for you whisky-loving people. So, find out more. Ralphie.com slant.